Hello everybody, I will show with this calculator Thales from 1925 a simple method on how to extract a square root with old mechanical calculators. You can use this method with every old calculator with a calculation counter, could be a arithmometer from 1897, a marchant from 1928, in Nissa from 1960 or any other. 30 seconds of theory based on the manual of the Ordner calculator. Calculating square roots could be considered all about subtracting consecutive odd numbers. For example, to obtain the square root of 16, you start subtracting from 16 the odd numbers, starting from 1, then 3, 5 and 7. There are 4 calculations, so square root of 16 is 4. You can do the same with every number. For example, if you subtract odd numbers from 49, you can do only 7 times before reaching 0. There are 7 subtractions, so square root of 49 is 7. But if you want to do this square root, you should do 569 subtractions, and it's not convenient. There is a method to do it. Let's see now how to do directly. It's simple. Let's start with this square root of 45,369. I move the carriage to the right. And I add the number on the calculator. I reset the counter, then I divide the number 45,369 in couples of 2, starting from right. The 4 is alone and I start from it. I subtract the first odd number 1. Then the second odd number, 3. Now there is the 0. I made 2 calculations. So 2 is the fourth number of this square root. Now there is 5,369 here in the dial. Now you pass to the other couple of numbers, the 53. Now you have to take the last number subtracted, the 3, you add 1, it's 4, and you put it here. Then you start again with the odd numbers from 1. You have 41, so you subtract it from 53. You can do only once. So the second number of the square root is 1. Now you have 1,269. I move the carriage 1 position. So again you take the last number subtracted, the 41, add 1 and it's 42. And you start again, adding at the end of the number the first odd number, the 1. And it's 421. So you start to subtract 421. And you go on with the odd numbers at the end of it. Then 423. Then 425. Now there is zero and it's not possible to subtract anything. You made three subtraction, so the last number is 3. Square root of 45,369 is 213. You can check with the calculator of your silly smartphone if you don't believe me. Maybe you think this is magic, or I've been lucky. But I will do it again with another square root. The square root of 16,38,89. Again, I divide it in groups of two, starting from right. And I start with the first group, 17. I raise the counter. As usual, I subtract the odd numbers from 17. 1, 3, 5, 7. There is one. It is not possible to subtract further. So fourth number is 4, since we made 4 subtractions. Now I take the last odd number subtracted, the 7, add 1, it's 8, and I add the first odd number, 1, and I have 81. I move the carriage one position, and I take the second couple, the 38. With the one remained, it's 138. I can subtract 81 from 138 only once. So the second number is 1. Now there is 5,789. I move the carriage one position, and I continue with the same criteria before. I take the 81, add 1, and it's 82. I add the first odd number, the 1, in the tail of the 82, and it's 81. And I start subtracting the 821 to the 5,789. Then I increase the last number with the following odd number, 823. Now there is zero. The calculation is finished. You cannot subtract further. You made 7 calculations, so last number is 7. So you have 417, and it's the square root. I know that doing a square root with a modern calculator is faster, but doing it with a mechanical calculator and seeing all the levers and gears moving has a kind of magic. Thanks for watching. Thank you.